Welcome back. I'm the RPG Chick. This is Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. We are about to enter the Hadret House. Do we have some kind of quest going on here? I think... Right. The Cipher works at Hadret's house. So we can find out if this guy Penhelm forged his... whatever. His affidavit that he's a peer of soul and of the Deerwood or something like that. See if the Cipher's in here. It's a pretty involved plot. The marble at the base has been worn smooth by the passage of hundreds of feet. People will just walk around it. Okay, we've got stairs. Dunreed agent. Curran's wasting his time with those disappearances. Lady Webb is in charge of Hadret House, but she rarely deals with anyone personally. It's rather snobbish of her. There are no secrets in Defiance Bay, not while we're around. Cute little one over here. There's Curran himself. This map shows the environs surrounding Defiance Bay. Flags mark strategic access points to the city. I can't even see that. I can't take it, of course. The scrolls are wedged tightly in the shelves. Each has a name scrawled along the outside. I want to read the names. Curran?
Well met, friend.
The Orlan man is surrounded by books and scrolls. His wiry hair stands nearly on end, and his ears prick up as you approach. You carry whispers. Cadnua, Gilded Veil. Old voices indeed. How did you know? The Orlan grins, revealing a row of dagger-pointed teeth. As a cipher, it's my job to know these things. You carry the whiff of ancients. What else can you tell me? His ears switch downward. Not as much as I would like, unfortunately. My duties for Lady Webb require me to focus my talents elsewhere. He regards a table piled with scrolls. What brings you to Dunreed Row? Let me wait on this. What are you so busy with? His small furry hands gesture expansively at the papers before him. Hollowborn, growing unrest, and the ever-present political intrigues. With so many missing souls, missing persons are the least of our concerns these days. Tell me more about your skills. I check for soul connections, looking for lost things, missing things, or troublesome things, particularly where people of power and influence are concerned. I'm a cipher. In Ir Glanfath, we were once known as Brishalgwin, mine hunters. Nice title, yes, but it wasn't until the Animancers began working with my kind 40 years ago that we truly understood our power. Now we make some of the best detectives in the world. Tracing souls, we can look at a person and see where they have been, or look at a weapon and see who has touched it. His nose twitches as he looks at you. Useful for solving crimes, as you can imagine. It looks as though you could use some help. Curran wags a clawed finger. Not at liberty to discuss my work, unfortunately. Dunreed Row, ears only. A civilian would need the confidence of Lady Webb before I could share. Okay, is this affidavit real? It's signed by you. He holds the page but seems to stare through the words as if something woven in the fabric of the paper. Curran bares his pointed teeth. I remember Penhelm. A preening peacock of a man, his mouth dry and hands moist when I told him he was a sole descendant of an Adarian general, one who'd fought against Hadret's rebellion. He scans the affidavit, a forgery, and not the first I've seen. He hands it back to you, but I've no time for the knights and their obsessions. Bring this to his commander, Cleaver, and show him the seal. He points to the wax stamped by his forged signature. If he compares it with another, he should be able to spot the difference. Okay. Aloth's gaze flickers to you. Doom a man for the soul the gods gave him? Seems unfair. Was I asking you, Aloth? Now, farewell. So we can help the guy with the dozens, you know. It's only so he can get his breastplate back. I mean, it's a means to an end. Plus, the guy's a jerk, so... that helps, too. Some of these vintages are even older than Defiance Bay. Wait till this guy walks away again and we can sneak.
Light! Flee!
What?
You can trust me.
Meat? What? That's it? Meat?
Eh?
Eh. Were we in there? I don't think we were in there. Or were we? No, you know, I don't think we were. A group of notes speculate about the identity and location of a secret sect in Defiance Bay. Either these notes are written in code, or the author's handwriting is atrocious. Someone coming in here. Now, sometimes when we talk to these people, they just get stuck, so I don't want to do that. Just waiting for him to leave again.
What? I can do that. A simple test.
That's not
a
simple.
A simple test.
We can't open either of these. Wow.
Eh? Really
tough stuff. The guy's stuck. A fine dagger. Affixed to the wall are leads in a case involving, apparently, a caravan that disappeared en route to New Haomar. Alright, now we're done down here. Thump, 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 thump. Alright, let's go up, left. The notes are scribbled in a cryptic shorthand. Anyone in here?
Slow and silent.
38 golden dukes. Hello there. If Lady Webb wants to see you, she'll send for you. Pictures of all manner of folk are pinned to this board alongside notes scribbled in an indecipherable shorthand. Whoa, I can't take those.
Hmm?
Quickly and quietly.
Hmm?
Can he stand in a place where they'll
like,
not see him? That's a good amount of money. There's too many people around. Way too many people around. And that's the other stairs, huh?
I'll take a look.
No, there's people all over here. We need someone with really good sneaking skills. We need a rogue. Alright, we're done here. So I don't know. Should we finish exploring here? Should we head back to, the Crucible Keep? Hmm. Hello? Penhelm and his knights. Penhelm's face is white. Just talked to the little Cipher, didn't you? One of my novitiates told me he'd seen someone in the records room. He takes a slow step toward you, extending his hand. Give me the affidavit. I've done nothing to you. His other hand comes to rest next to his sword. Interesting. I guess the game wouldn't have allowed us to just walk away, right? I'm having a hard time choosing between 3 and 4. I'm not giving it to him. Your superiors deserve to know the truth. What truth? That over a century ago, I was some Adirin who's dust in the ground now? His hand grips the sword panel. I'll ask you one more time. Give that back. I am not interested in fighting you. Then you should have minded your own business. He draws his sword. I won't let you destroy my career over this. Okay, guys. Alright, guys. Head to the rear, Aloth. Aether, yeah. Knockdown. Boom. We're just gonna pile on him for now. We have to wait till combat begins to do that. I'm just gonna wait for him to run back. Links nearby enemies to the target, forcing them. Okay. I guess we can't cast that yet. Let me just do my standard, How much does this take? 20 focus. Of which we have 27. Oh, we can't cast that. Can't cast anything yet. You know what? Soul Ignition. On Penhelm. And go! And we can now do this.
Yes.
Okay, Loth. Fireball. Oh, there's someone right there. I would have got him, huh? And interrupted him, too. I'd say... again. Hope we're not catching our guy. Knockdown again. Sagani, sure. Hit this guy. Oh, Canna, what are you doing?
Hi.
Oh, wait, he has the... No, use your sword. Does anyone else have ranged out? Okay. Necrotic Lance on Penhelm.
Hey.
And target this novitiate now. Oh boy. Oh boy. Throw some healing. Can't reach us all. Oh boy. Heal us! Thank you. I think we're gonna have to go again with that. Who is this? Is anyone hitting Theodas? Looks like he's hitting Eater, I think. Hit to Mac, yeah. Everyone attacked this guy except me. This guy's almost down. Injured, barely injured. Aloth, yeah, he's down. That's better. Wow. The wolf was growling. I mean, the fox was growling. Well, we need a rest. Swords. Breastplate, helm. Osric's family breastplate. This old breastplate has its share of battle scars, but it's clearly been well preserved over the years and still bears some of its original shine. The symbol of a flame is emblazoned across the middle. Cool. Well, he saved us the trouble of going back to the Crucible Keep. Now, what about the knights? Are we gonna get attacked by anyone? We need to go rest. That's one thing we really need to do. Why, this was flashing, but nothing new to report. Average adventure. Oh, we have an adventure we can assign to somebody. We need people in order to do that. I wonder if we can talk to him. This cipher and tell him, oh, Penfold's dead now.
Welcome!
Nope. No option. Need to go rest. We might get attacked by these knights regularly now. I don't know. Hopefully we're not stuck in some unwinnable state where we can't do anything. Or go anywhere without getting attacked and killed. You wouldn't do that to me, would you, Pillars of Eternity? You wouldn't do that to me.
And well met.
Let's see your rooms. Huh, we only have these two. Criminal's Getaway or Noble's Stay. How about Criminal's Getaway? Plus 2 perception, 1 survival. 150 copper. Ah, nothing better. Okay. You know, Copper Lane's right there. So that's a nice... Duty and Spirit. Okay. I guess they don't know there were no witnesses that we killed them. Here, and we need to go to there. Hey, hey, hey! Breastplate's on the way. Is this the armor you wanted? Osric wavers a moment in disbelief. He looks at you, then back at the breastplate. Then he looks back at you, then even back at the breastplate. He reaches for it slowly, as if expecting it to disappear before he can touch it. How did you manage this? You were right about the affidavit. Unfortunately, Penhelm forced me into a fight. Shame it ended like that. But he's the lying weasel who started this. You did all I asked, and you are owed much. He withdraws a leather coin purse from his pocket and hands it to you. Stop by Sunil's shop on the other side of the hall. She sells some of the best gear in the city, and I'll see that she opens her inventory to you. What is this armor to you, anyway? Osric looks around, trying to appear casual. It's nothing, really. Just a keepsake. Isn't it an heirloom for his family heirloom? He tries to look you in the eye, but when he does, he appears to reconsider. He sighs. It commemorates the Order of Magrin, highest order of valor, awarded to the dead, never the living. Us dear woodens, real dear woodens, we don't have nobility or birthrights, unless you're some, copper, from Adir, I'm not gonna say that. All we got's the honor to bring to our family name. Adir says the Order of Magrin is, well, they don't give it out too much. Not often you see a member of the dozens whose revolutionary ties are as good as he says they are. So this, he pauses, considering the weathered metal, a pale image of its former self, but still catching the light, is something to look up to. Or to live up to. Quest completed. Azric seemed to regret Penhelm's death, but he was glad to have his breastplate back. Alright, he didn't seem any regret to me. Just like, oh, whatever. Thanks for the breastplate. How'd you do it? You're awesome. So give us 2,000 copper. And we're getting lots of quest experience lately. Pretty awesome. I guess we'll go see this lady. She'd be like, not every day I sell things to a civilian, something like that. Oh, this isn't where she is. It's here. Duh. So the wilds haven't claimed you yet. She smiles. Good to see you again. Oh, she doesn't have anything to say. Okay. So we've got exceptional kind of things. Okay, so exceptional, I guess, is plus 8 accuracy and plus 30 damage. Thirteen to 20 pierce versus deflection. You know what I want to do? Whenever we have enough money, I want to get exceptional, I guess, 17 to 26. I'm guessing war bows for everybody. This way we'll all fire at once and that'll be our starting shot. Bracers of all consuming rage. That is funny. When the husband and children of Elena Skycleaver were captured by Terwin the Blackhearted, she and her troops besieged his castle, hoping to negotiate her family's return. Instead, Terwin had them impaled on the battlements while Elena watched from below. Upon seeing the atrocity, Elena abandoned all rational thought and ran screaming toward Terwin's castle, first in anguish, then in rage. To the surprise of all present, Elena suddenly stopped screaming and burst into flames, supposedly touched by Magrin herself. Terwin's soldiers loosed their arrows, but Elena didn't even slow. She struck the castle gates like a battering ram, bursting through and scattering Terwin's soldiers. Desperate to escape her fury, those who remained threw their master into her path. Her flames engulfed him, and no one knows if the unearthly scream that followed came from him or from her. But within minutes, both of them had burnt to ashes. Only these bracers survived. These bracers are made of bronze covered in a dark green patina. Etched into the metal is a picture of a slender humanoid engulfed in flames. Strangely enough, the humanoid has no head, only two orbs where the eyes would normally be. So this is plus two might and plus one constitution. Bracers, huh? Dandy hat of the diseased yak. Plus two resolve, minus one intellect. The legend behind this hat is that it once belonged to a famed prince of a small kingdom that was conquered and absorbed into the Adirian Empire. The prince and his court were known for their outlandish dress, but not, unfortunately, for prowess in battle. In fact, when the prince learned that the Adirian army was marching toward him, he threw a fabulous party to welcome the invaders. This hat survived the war and subsequent occupation, has been traded in many a dark corner by those wishing to further their social standing with panache. Lined with garish purple silk and adorned with a large chartreux feather, the hat makes a strong, if questionable, fashion statement. Well, yeah, it makes you, kind of makes you stupider, but it gives you more resolve. Snurf's Folly. Plus one resolve, plus two constitution. Once belonging to the wife of a noted animancer known as Snurf, this white gold wedding ring is set with a central pink stone flanked by two small diamonds. The shrine of the gem stands in stark contrast to the grimy, worn band. It is rumored that while his love was ill and on the brink of death, the desperate animancer performed a radical experiment to merge her soul with his. According to most versions of the tale, her already weakened body was unable to withstand the strain of the binding. While this process extinguished the little life left in her body, it overwhelmed her soul, fragmenting it into oblivion. Overcome with guilt and despair, the once great man lived out the rest of his days in a Svef-induced madness, holding on to the hope that he might somehow glimpse traces of her soul amongst his own pitiful reflection. That's horrible. Bile Stompers grants minor fetid caress. Corrode bonus plus five damage reduction. These boots were created in a small village in the Living Lands that is bordered by a toxic swamp and frequently overrun by venomous weeds. Though the hard soles have withstood years of use, the edges of the leather show signs of corrosion. It's believed that some of the venom has seeped into the boots. No, I don't want to compare that. Cloak of the Fox and Hunter. Grants summon noble creature. I wonder if it has like charges or it's infinite. Plus 5 will, plus 10 reflex. Pretty cool. A dear wooden legend tells the story of a hunter who spent days in the woods trying to find food for her family. In her first trap, she caught a boar. "Please, great hunter," the boar begged when she approached. "I am no ordinary boar. I am the ruler of my kind. If you free me, I will reward you greatly." So the hunter freed the boar, who ran off laughing, never to be seen again. Her second trap caught a turkey. "Please, powerful hunter," the turkey said when she approached. "I am no ordinary turkey. I am the ruler of my kind. If you free me, you will get rewards such that you cannot imagine." So the hunter released a turkey, who also ran off laughing, never to be seen again. The final trap held a fox. "Please, mighty hunter," the fox began as she approached. "I will not free you," said the hunter. "Already I have lost two wonderful meals. I will not lose a third. If you truly will reward me, then I will free you. But you must leave something of yours behind, so I know you will return." So the fox left behind the length of its legs, enchanting the hunter's cape with its grace and reflexes. The fox returned to its kind, but was rejected for its short-legged appearance. "You look like a dog," her fellows taunted. No longer welcome among her kind, the fox returned to the hunter and offered another deal. She would aid the hunter in all endeavors as payment for her life. This cloak represents the bargain between the fox and the hunter. Weathered and worn, this cloak is tan with light splotches. When pulled over the head, the corners look like erect dog ears. That's so cool. I actually love that story. Manacra Arat. Well, whatever it is, you wear it in the helm on the head and grants Whisper of Treason plus 15 will. This exquisite piece was crafted by alchemists for a secret society of aristocrats in Old Valia. Throughout its history, it has graced the ocular orbits of scheming nobles, influential politicians, and charming salesmen. The dark brass monocle features intricate gear and leaf filigree along the rim. It confers sophistication and carries the unmistakable scent of old money. And Berserker's Belt. Only usable by Barbarian. Excuse me. Of which we do not have. Plus 20 Frenzy Duration. Rage bonus. This belt was the product of a strange collaboration between the famed Barbarian Stronger, and an animancer of comparatively lesser fame. Strungber was determined to extend the period in which he could cast himself into fearless frenzy, for it was the means by which he survived some of his many battles. The animancer, in turn, was much intrigued by the opportunity to investigate the affliction of temper. Over a period of time, the trigger for Strungber's rage was isolated, and the belt was imbued with a spell which mimicked the effect. The resulting damage done to the laboratory ensured that the pair never collaborated again, but Strungber was very pleased with the belt he received. Now, the will defense opposes attacks that are mentally based. Oh wait, no. I just want to look at it. Grants summon noble creature. That's expensive, but... yeah. And we can sell this crap. Did I add that? Okay, good. Well, lion hide, yeah, we don't want that. I suppose I could craft with it, but whatever. Duplicate books. Okay. Who should I give this cloak to? Max endurance bonus. You know what? His endurance is 105 or 90. I want to give this to Aloth just to give him a little help. 15 extra hit points. She's already got a companion. So I'm going to give this cloak. You know what? Give it to Eater. I like the idea of Eater having a... a cloak like that. Now, where did I put it? Where is it? Oh.
Hey.
Summon noble creature. Cool. A beagle. A beagle. Oh my god, I was hoping it'd be like a bear. A rhino or something. Longer episode this time. Where the hell am I?
You had 5 siblings?
That's right. Between the 6 of us, I don't think the house has known a single day's quiet. Of course, a little chaos makes it far easier to get away with mischief.
Yes, I can imagine that comes in handy.
Alright, thanks for watching, everyone. See you in the next episode when we explore more of Blackberry. Endure, and enduring, grow strong.